Good morning, good evening, friends. So today we are starting with another topic, that is food hazards of natural origin. These are natural toxins that are the toxic compounds that are naturally produced by the living organisms for their self-defense. That means animals, to defend themselves from their predators, they have adopted some toxins. They have developed some toxins in their body so that they can harm to the predator. So these toxins are not harmful to the organism themselves, but they may be toxic to the other creatures. In this, there are different types, that is aquatic biotics, pyrrolidazine alkaloids, cyanogenic glycosides, biogenic amines, phenolic compounds, protease inhibitors and phytates. So now let's learn about phytates. Phytates are phytic acids. These are high in foods like grains and nuts. And if someone is already suffering from zinc or iron deficiency, this will worsen them. So that means, what are phytic acids basically do? They bind to the essential minerals like iron, zinc, calcium, magnesium in the digestive tract. So whatever the food that is digested, it has to, the nutrients of that food will be absorbed in the villi of the large intestine. So when the nutrients are getting absorbed, these phytic acids, they will bind to these minerals, iron, zinc, calcium and magnesium, and they will inhibit them from getting absorbed into the body. So thus they are inhibiting their absorption by the body. And this can be reduced by soaking the grains and nuts. Soaking, that is why we prefer eating almonds and pulses to be soaked and then cooked. This will reduce the phytate content and also increase the nutritional value, and thus reducing the anti-nutrient properties present in the grains. So it is always preferred to soak the grains and eat. And even sprouts are also very good, as they are soaked and then sprouted, so they will have rich in the vitamins and minerals. So they will be reducing the phytate contents and ensures the all the nutrients from that pulses are getting into our body. Next, we have aquatic biotics. These are algal toxins from shellfishes such as mussels, scallops, and these are more toxic than fishes. It causes diarrhea when someone takes this kind of things. If that is having an algal toxin, then it will lead to diarrhea, vomiting, tingling and paralysis. What is tingling? Is the prickling sensation. So when under this, so sometimes we feel like something is pricking us from the inside. That feeling is called tingling. They don't have any taste or smell, so they cannot be eliminated by cooking also, these algal toxins. So one of the best example is ciguatera fish poisoning caused by fish contaminated by dinoflagellates like ciguat toxins. So dinoflagellates are a kind of alga, and when these dinoflagellates, when they are contaminated by ciguat toxins, then that will lead to the problem called ciguatera fish poisoning. And this can be seen in fishes like barracuda, black groups, dog snapped, king mackerel. Symptoms include nausea, vomiting and neurological problems. Next, we have pyrrolidazine alkaloids. These alkaloids are mostly obtained from the plant sources of family Boraginaceae, Asteraceae, Fabaceae, and mostly the plant sources are of these plants are mostly weeds, not the useful parts, but the weed forms usually have these toxins. And they have the DNA damaging potential, and that will lead to cancer. And these can be detected in herbal teas, honey, herbs, spices and other foods. Next, we have alkaloids. So what are alkaloids? Alkaloids are glycoalkaloids. These are steroidal alkaloids coupled to one or more monosaccharides, usually of Solanaceae family. So as soon as we listen to the name of Solanaceae, so we usually get remembered of brinj all or potato. So now we are dealing with the potato. So potato will have alpha solanine and alpha chalconine in high levels. They are in high levels in green potatoes. Potatoes which are green in color, those are not preferred to eat because they will have alpha solanine and alpha chalconine, and this will give them a bitter taste and a burning sensation. And it has what is the reason? Because of the presence of this alpha solanine and alpha chalconine in high levels, green potatoes will give us bitter taste and burning sensation, and it is not preferred to eat such kind of potatoes. Next, it has saponin-like properties, and how they function is by disrupting the membrane function in the gastrointestinal tract, leading to hemorrhagic damage. This is how they are affecting our body. Next, we have biogenic amines. In biogenic amines, we have histamine. So, biogenic amines are, these are amines which are present naturally, so bio in the life forms. These, the example of this is histamine intoxication. It is previously known as chromboid fish poisoning due to high levels of intake of histamine. So histamine intolerance will result in histamine degradation due to lower deaminase oxidase activity. So then the ferment, so this histamine is intolerance is caused due to histamine degradation due to deaminase oxidase is enzyme. When that is reduced, then the histamine intolerance happens. Whenever someone is getting histamine food, it will give a negative reaction to them. And one more is fermenting lactic acid bacteria. They produce biogenic amines. These microorganisms, they will decarboxylate amino acids. That means they will remove the carboxyl part of the amino acid, especially like histamine, tryptamine, monoamine oxidase inhibitors. So previously, histamine intolerance is due to diamine oxidase, and lactic acid, histamine, tryptamine, others is due to monoamine oxidase inhibitor. Next, we have tyramine toxicity. The tyramine toxicity is due to, it is also called cheese reaction. So when Lactobacillus buchneri, they outbreak of histamine poisoning on cheese. These are the organisms responsible for, what is the organism responsible for cheese reaction or tyramine toxicity is that Lactobacillus buchneri is a microorganism. They are having enzyme histidine decarboxylase that converts histidine to histamine. So histidine is very important amino acid, essential amino acid. But this histidine, because these have the potential to removal of the carboxyl part of amino acid, this histidine will convert it into histamine. Histidine is the essential amino acid that we need, but that histidine will not be present in that form to be taken by the body, and it will be converted into a histamine, which is a biogenic amine that is harmful to the body. Next, we have phenolic compounds. So phenolic compounds are hydroxycinnamic acid derivatives, and flavonoids are bioactive. The enzymatic browning reaction of polyphenolic compound is catalyzed by polyphenol oxidase, that is PPO. So what is polyphenol oxidase? That is PPO is polyphenol oxidase that is catalyzed. When this polyphenol oxidase is catalyzed, it will cause the formation of an undesirable color and flavor, that is browning color. browning color. That is called enzymatic browning. That is caused due to, that is called due to what? PPO, that is polyphenol oxidases. Okay. Then what this polyphenol, other than this, whatever, what this will do is, they will, the double stand, it will create double stranded breaks in the DNA, and DNA and causes mutations and also chromosomal aberrations in the body when someone takes the food that is having the phenolic compounds in it. It will result in double stranded breaks and DNA abduction, mutations and chromosomal aberrations also as well. Next we have protease inhibitors. Protease inhibitors are inhibitors of enzymes like trypsin and chymotrypsin, usually present in intestine, and these are present in soya beans. Next we have biogenic amines. So biogenic amines, for your clear understanding, I have made one more video, one more slide, so don't get confused, it is the same one. So in this I have added the steps clearly. So histamine intoxication is due to high intake of histamine, as you know, and amino acid histamine degradation due to lower deaminase activity. Histamine is degraded due to lower deaminase activity, and bacteria like Lactobacillus butyneri produce decarboxylate the amino acid. That means they remove the carboxyl part, and they will convert this histidine to histamine, histidine is an essential amino acid, but that amino acid, it will be converted into histamine, and that will lead to a problem. That's all, we are done with this lesson, and thank you everyone. If you need some other topic which is hard for you, please let me know in the comment section. If you like my video, please give a like button and subscribe me for some more videos. I'll be happy to hear from you. Thank you.